Welcome, traveler, to this visit to Nambung National Park, or more specifically, the Pinnacles. The Pinnacles is located about 19 kilometers from the town of Cervantes on the Indian Ocean. There's a well-paved road that runs from Cervantes along the ocean to the Pinnacles Desert. This Google satellite photo is not very high definition, but it shows the desert on the bottom right and the town of Cervantes on the very top left. A closer view of the desert. The round dots are photographs. This is about as high resolution as possible. The top left is the access road, and then it's possible to drive around the desert for a couple of hours on a pathway through the sand. The Pinnacles is not called the Pinnacles Desert. The raw material for the limestone of the Pinnacles comes from seashells of an earlier epoch, rich in marine life. The Pinnacles were formed from lime leaching from the sand into the lower levels of the dune and into the soft limestone. Vegetation forms an acidic layer of soil and humus. A hard cap develops above the limestone. Cracks in the calcrete are exploited by plant roots, and the softer limestone continues to dissolve. Quartz sand fills the channels. Vegetation dies, and winds blow away the sand, covering the eroded limestone, thus revealing the Pinnacles. The area receives 250,000 visitors a year and costs about $10 per car or $4 per person. This newspaper article categorizes it as one of Australia's seven natural landmarks. There are many news articles about the Pinnacles, and they're all pretty positive. They talk about misshapen columns, saw-shaped profiles, like the teeth of a large dragon. Others resemble giant petrified mushrooms. They're 140 miles north of Perth, and the pillars dot two-thirds of a 68-acre park. Another favorable article, High on the Pinnacles, in the Singapore Straits Times. We're on our way in, and we drive along the coast. There's immense sand dunes between the road and the coastline. I turn in to the coast to have a look at the beach. It's a wonderful beach. I think it's called Nambung Bay. I reached the old visitor center, which was still in use, November 2007. It's been replaced by this one. The new interpretive center was still under construction. Looks wonderful when it opens. The only interpretation I saw were these two small signs. A complex of three sand dune systems are aligned parallel to the coast, formed from windblown beach sand deposited over the last 2 million years. I learned about the hardy dune vegetation, which is, halophilic or salt loving, tolerates salt and sand of the sea. Thickets of acacias occupy the more protective small valleys. There's a description of how the Pinnacles is formed. In the diagram, you can see the distinctive cap of calcrete on the Pinnacles, which gradually cracks. Plants grow, and the winds gradually blow the sand away. The pinnacles are left, along with the monitor lizards. Yet another description from Wikipedia. It's kind of hard to take it all in at once. The welcome sign. There's a sand track that you can drive in a normal sedan through the pinnacles. It took me about 2 hours going quite slowly. Here's the route. It's about 3.5 kilometers. There's a pinnacles lookout, but being in a wheelchair, it wasn't accessible, so I kept moving. Here's the walkway to the lookout. The day I was there, there was a strong sea breeze, a lot of wind-blowing sand. It's almost like a desert storm. The view disappears in a blizzard of sand. The pathway is shown here. It's quite okay for normal vehicles. No need for a four-wheel drive. It's well marked by small boulders. Thanks, traveler, for joining me on this trip to Nambung National Park, and specifically a visit to the Pinnacles, Western Australia. I do appreciate your company, and I appreciate you watching this short slideshow. I do wish you a very pleasant day.